But God, in his goodness, and let me leave you with these words right here, so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. He didn't send his Son to condemn the tenants of this vineyard, but to save them. Don't you understand? That's how much he wanted this vineyard, that he would overlook their sins. Not overlook. There had to be a judgment paid. He just wasn't going to take it out on them. He was going to take it out on his Son. Because without the shedding of blood, there can be no forgiveness of sin. So we couldn't just give him a pass. He had to find a way to pay for it. And he found that in Jesus. So what we used as evil, what we thought was, we gotta own the place. God said, no, you don't even understand. You playing right into this, because he has to shed his blood that you might have your forgiveness. Otherwise, I gotta take it out your hide. And you don't want that, my man. But the debt is already paid if you would but believe. Because I didn't send Jesus in to condemn. I sent him in to save you. Whoever believes in him is not condemned. But whoever does not believe stands condemned already, because they have not believed in the name of God's one and only Son, the name of Jesus Christ. There is no other. It wasn't going to be Isaac. It's not going to be another that comes later. He has been here. He has been raised up on that cross. He has died on that cursed tree. He was buried and he rose again to the power side of God. And now through that good news, because of what he has done, because he was that perfect lamb, that perfect sacrifice given for us, we can have life if we want it. That's your choice, my man. That's your choice, young lady. Like, it's up to you. Every one of us got to make that decision, because every one of us individually going to have to stand before God and give account of what we did with this gospel. And I'm just trying to tell you, here's how you reconcile. You believe in what he has done. He spilled perfect blood that if we come underneath it, we are washed up. Just like when I throw my boys in the shower after they're done wallowing in that mud, they clean. And I could take them out and I could bring them to town. And he's saying the same thing. I want you at my feast, but you ain't coming looking like that. You got to put the right clothes on, and I got them for you. And to get washed, you got to believe in that heart and confess with their mouth, Jesus is Lord. Ain't no other way. But if you should do that, you have salvation. He is not a respecter of persons. It don't matter about age, culture, creed, color, sex. It don't matter. If you believe in the name of Jesus, you have been reconciled back to your Father, because Jesus did all the work, because Jesus paid the price, because Jesus was the Lamb sent by God.